I never did invest too much money anywhere. I'm not an investor, I'm a gambler. I invest my money in the bankroll.
And the term gambler fits Benny Binion like an old shoe. Solid, comfortable, a little worn around the edges. 77 years young, a Las Vegan for over 30 years, Benny and the Binion family run the downtown Horseshoe Club, but more often than not, you'll find Benny on his Montana ranch. 250 sections of working ranch. Benny, it is so peaceful up here. You talk about how much you like the casino atmosphere and the gambling, the excitement of all the people, and yet this is an entirely different world.
I don't like this climate.
Boy, what don't you like about it?
Well, it ain't but about 2 months out of the year. It's a good climate. Starting in right now. Now, by August 1st, it'll be hot as the desert. And then by November the 1st, it'll be cold as Alaska.
But you're up here a lot.
Yeah.
Why?
Stuck with it.
Oh, come on.
No, I like it. Yeah. I was trotting along behind some horses up here a while back. I was kind of tired, and I said, look at me, I'm a damn fool. I've been trotting along behind these things for 69 years.
You ever going to keep up with them?
Try.
Yeah, yeah.
Do my best.
A lot of people say they'd rather be around horses than other people. What do you think about
that?
Oh,
no, I like people, too. They're a little good in everybody. But if they ain't no good in me, don't have to pay no attention to them. Get away from them. In 1947, there's a man came in dressed like $1 million, had his money in his hand like this, just like a dice cheater would work out from under the money. Don't you see any dealing off like that, betting the money? So he lost $11,000, and he just went to wringing his hands and talking to the Lord, just having a fit. And I said, my God, I've seen everything. What is this? Well, we got a hold of him and treat him real nice. I said, hold on, and take him back there and set him down. So he told us a story. He's a minister from a city, and he decided he just wanted to do some drinking and gambling. He don't know what happened. He just come and lost that money. And by the time he lost it, he realized what had happened to him. So we was talking, and he said, I don't know where I'll go back and tell the congregation and ask for forgiveness or what I'll do. Well, I said, I'll tell you what, I'm going to give you $1,000. He didn't have no more money. I was going to give you $1,000 to go home on. And if you don't get along on it, I'll send you some more, don't you see? So I said, don't tell the congregation. I don't believe they'll forgive you. I said, the Lord will forgive you. That's the only one that's going to forgive you. So about 6 months, he wrote me a letter with a cashier's check for $1,000. And he said he never felt better in his life. He'd never told nobody, and he's positive nothing like that ever happened to him again. I'll tell you what, I never did consider anybody as gambling as weakness. A gambler is an over-energetic person. He's not a weak person. He's the best hustler in the world. But if he's weak, he couldn't be that kind of hustler. Just like one day, there's a waitress lost her money in the horseshoe and told me, she said, give me $15, I got to feed my children. Well, I give her the $15, and my son said, I don't see how she makes it. I said, the hell you don't. I said, you see her get 15 from me? They ain't no telling how many more she's getting 15 from.
Is it just the money? Is it just the money that makes people want to gamble?
No, I think it's the excitement. They like it, you know, it steams them up. Now, I'm talking for the gambler, all right. But I honestly think them slot machines is good for them old ladies. They don't, they've been coming in there, some of them, for 20 years. They get them a little scotch and water and sip on it and play them slot machines to get tired to go home and rest. And the next day, they get freshened up, come back. They've been doing it forever, and they just seem like me to do better than anybody. I think they do better than the people that come in wheelchairs. I admire them. A person will get out and let somebody push him around, push him up out of that wheelchair. He ain't going to just sit and die.